Okay, I'd like to do another KD tree example. K stands for the number of dimensions that are being used to determine how to insert the data into the tree. And this time I would like to do it for K equals 3 rather than the simpler K equals 2. Now, a KD tree is always a binary tree. And the point of the binary tree for a KD tree is that every time you step down, you make a decision, you are going to make a decision based on one of the three dimensions of concern, and as you step down the level, you cycle through your three dimensions. So let's go ahead and enter this into an initially empty KD tree where K equals 3. And so as I cycle through the dimensions, I'll go through the X dimension, and then the Y dimension, and then the Z dimension as I go down through the tree. And to reflect this, I'm going to change colors between red, green, and blue. So let's start with red, which will be the first node that I insert into the tree. And this will be an X decision level right here. And the data I enter is the 371. Okay, so the next piece of data I'm going to enter is the 811. And so I start at the root right here. And 8 is greater than 3. So I will go down the right branch right there. And I'm going to enter a green node then. So 811. So this was to go from here to here was an X decision. 8 is greater than 3. Takes care of that. Now I enter the 662. Okay, so I start here. 6 is greater than 2. So I go down this branch. Now I'll be comparing the Y dimensions. So I compare the 6 against the 1. And the 6 is greater than the 1. So I'll go to the right. And I'll need a blue color. So that's my 662. Okay, next I have a 264, so I start with the root, and 2 is less than or equal to 3, so I'll go down to the left, and I'm at a leaf node here, so now I will enter the 264 at the leaf node, so I'll need my green, 264. Okay, next is 271, I start here, 2 is less than or equal to 3, so I go down the left child. Then I look at the 7 and I compare that against the 6. 7 is greater than 6, so I'll go to the right and that will give me a right child. I enter 271 to the right child. Okay, now I have 988. Okay, 9 is greater than 3, so I go to the right. Now I compare this 1 against this 8. 8 is greater than 1, so I go to the right. Now I compare this 8 right here against this 2. And this 8 is greater than that 2, so I go to the right. And so I will have my red node next, which is 988. Okay. Now 571. 5 is compared to 3. 5 is greater than 3. Go to the right. 7 is compared to 7. 7 is less than or equal to 7, so I go to the left. I'm recording. And I enter at that point. Okay. Now I have 5, 6, 3. 5 is greater than 3, go to the right. 6 is greater than 1, looking at the Y dimension, so I go to the right. 3 is greater than 2, so I go to the right. Now I cycle around, so now I'm making a decision on the X dimension. 5 is less than 9, so I go to the left. That gives me a green node. 5, 6, 3. Okay, so up here I have the X dimension where I make the decision at that node. Then I have Y, making the decision based on the Y dimension, and then I have my Z, and then I cycle around X, and then Y, and then so on, all the way down the tree. So that you can see it's still a binary tree. I can have as many dimensions as I need to in the tree. 5 dimensions would be a 5D tree. Okay, so let us suppose that I'm looking for data item, how about 899? Is it present in the tree? Okay, 8 is greater than 3, go to the right. 9 is greater than this one right here, go to the right. 9 is greater than this 2, this 9 right here, the z9 is greater than this 2, so I go to the right. Now I'm looking at the x. X is less than 9, so I go to the left. Okay, this 9 right here is greater than 6, so I look to the right, and it's empty, so the answer is no. This data is not present in the tree.